everyone, Dan here at Fanatik. I'm here with Rich today to tell you about RockShox's entirely new line of forks and rear shocks. Let's jump in. We got a lot to cover.
Yeah, so first things we're looking at is the whole new lineup of forks from RockShox's. So they have completely redesigned the Lyrik, the Pike, and the Zeb, and there's a ton of new features in these forks. First up, we're looking at the stanchions on these forks. They've kind of designed these things to have specific travel ranges, and in doing so, they've shortened the overall length of the stanchions that live inside of the lower legs, which means a lighter fork. So the Pike is intended for 120 millimeters to 140 millimeter bikes. The Lyrik here is intended for 140 to 160 bikes, and the Zeb that I got to ride is intended for 160 to 190 travel bikes. So, like I mentioned, we have the shorter stanchions, lighter overall package. Inside of the lower legs of these forks, we have brand new bushings. Now those bushings lead to a stiffer overall feel on all of the fork lineup. Those bushings have channels in them that allow oil to flow freely throughout the fork, keeping everything lubed and running smooth. And speaking of oil, RockShox’s has teamed up with Maxima to formulate an entire new suspension oil for these forks. The previous stuff that they use is great, but they've just taken it to a whole nother level with this Maxima oil. And the good news is it is also compatible with your older forks. So if you're not buying the new Ultimate fork, and you just need to do a service on your current Pike, Lyrik, or Zeb, you can use the new Maxima oils, which is great for upgrading. If you look at the back of these legs, RockShox’s has also added pressure release valves. Now, Fox introduced these on their forks about 2 years ago, and now RockShox’s has joined the party, and these little pressure release valves help you if you're riding like really big elevation gain days. You can kind of get some air buildup in the lower legs of these forks, hit the little airport bleeders, and your fork is gonna be riding like it's brand new. Then as we move down to the fork, we're looking at the dropouts here. And on all three of these forks, RockShox has added these little spacers. So if your wheels or your hubs don't come with torque caps, you can have these little spacers on there. It makes throwing the wheel into the dropouts much easier, lines up, gets the axle in there. And then if you are running torque caps on your hubs or wheels, it's a little 3 mil Allen key. You pull those adapters out and you can slide your torque cap wheel right in there. So that is a bunch of the new stuff on these forks.
Last thing I wanted to touch on is that RockShox has brought in that kind of aggressive angular styling that we saw introduced on the Zeb throughout their entire line. So we've got these mean looking, you know, fork crowns or arches that, and that does translate through to the entire lineup, which is pretty cool thing. I think the whole package looks really, really good.
On that new arch, the Zeb previously had a bolt-on fender. They now have a bolt-on fender that is specific to the Pike and the Lyrik as well. So yeah, it's a great feature. Get rid of those zip ties. No more rubbing the paint off the lowers of your fork, mm-hmm, and keep that mud out of your face.
So it is the same fender for both the Pike and the Lyrik. Pretty cool. Now onto the internals, where a lot of the really exciting stuff is happening on these forks. Gone is the Charger 2.1 damper that we've gotten pretty used to. RockShox’s has completely redesigned their damper and is now calling it the Charger 3 damper. And one of the most interesting things that you'll see on this is how they've sort of oriented it for adjustments on their now high and low speed compressions. Instead of starting fully screwed in like you would on any traditional damper and then opening it up from there to get to where you need to go, RockShox has designed these with very tight tolerances to all start sort of at a neutral setting, which you'll see with a thicker line. And you would start on the middle for both high and low speed compression. That's whether you're 120 pounds or 220 pounds, because the air spring is going to be what's actually supporting your rider weight. And then from there, you'll see a plus and a minus, and you can decrease that compression, whether it's high speed or low speed, or increase it. I think this is a big deal. It makes it a lot more intuitive for riders to say, okay, I'm running through some rollers and I'm pumping too far into the travel, so I'm going to increase my low speed compression, but I don't want to mess with my high speed compression in case I, you know, front wheel case a jump or something like that.
So that's a really cool thing, is RockShox within this damper has completely separated the high and low speed compression adjustment. And like Dan mentioned, there's that nice easy middle setting. I'm somebody who doesn't typically mess with all of the clicks of high and low speed compression because I can get lost in the clicks really easily. This makes it super easy and intuitive to adjust your fork, and it's definitely something I'm looking forward to because I do kind of want to like get those benefits of playing around with settings on my fork, but I don't want to like completely whack things out, have a funky ride, and not know how to get back to that base setting. So really intuitive how they've done these adjustments on this fork, and I'm really excited about that.
Now, the new way of doing the adjustments on that high and low speed circuit might be the most visible part of the new damper, but it's far from the only new thing. Like I said, they have redesigned this from the ground up. Now, if you've ever pulled a Charger 2.1 damper out of your fork, you might notice that the expanding rubber bladder that used to live up here is gone. They have replaced that with an internal floating piston. What that is a little piston here with a metal spring behind it that when oil gets pushed up into this compression assembly here, that is able to kind of move out of the way and allow for that fluid to move into that chamber, much like that expanding bladder used to do. For the more tech savvy of you, you might recognize a similar maneuver from Fox a few years ago when they replaced the RC2 damper with the Grip2 damper and did the exact same thing. Now, this is not a bad thing. This design has a number of advantages. First one being that it can actually self-bleed. Underneath that piece of tape there is a little bleed port where if there's too much oil in this damper, it can actually just purge out. So that means oil can actually move in from the bottom, and if too much gets in, it can purge out at the top. All of that is the result of less friction, oil being able to get in the bottom, which is a good thing for our forks. We don't want friction when we're looking for a supple feel on a fork. It also means that there's just less sort of maintenance for this thing. It's easier to rebuild. It requires fewer tools to rebuild. And in fact, it's actually pretty dang simple. Not that I recommend pulling it out of your fork and doing it at home. Is this thing better than a Grip 2 damper? Well, I haven't ridden one yet. I don't know. I'm not knowledgeable enough to take it apart and be able to tell you by looking at it, but we are looking forward to getting on one and trying it out.
Yeah, so like Dan mentioned, serviceability. These dampers are way easier to work on. There's no specialty tools needed, and RockShox is supporting it with a bunch of aftermarket parts. So if you do run into a problem, you can take it to your local suspension tuner or your local shop. They can get the parts, they can fix your damper. That wasn't possible on the Charger 2.1, so that's a huge improvement on the Charger 3, which is really exciting. Now, compression isn't the only thing on this, Dan. Rebound, down at the bottom.
Yes.
It's only one dial, mm-hmm. which me, the less tech savvy, are really excited about. But why'd they only do one?
Well, you have seen on the Grip 2 damper that Fox is pretty stoked on having split that up into high and low speed rebound. They're doing their variable valve control on the high speed rebound, and that's awesome. But for a lot of us out there, it's kind of a lot to deal with. So having one rebound adjustment that covers the broad range of rebound just makes it that much easier for the user to be able to get the exact feel they're looking for out of this.
Yeah, I look forward to that because you can definitely, again, get lost in the clicks, and only having one adjuster down there is great. I know that when we talked with RockShox about this, there's also another part mm-hmm. in the damper called the silencer.
Oh, yeah.
What's the silencer do?
Yeah, so in that rebound circuit, one thing that they have done is added, I don't know the exact mechanics of it, but they, like Rich said, they're calling it the silencer. And when the fork is rebounding, it decreases turbulence in the oil and basically gets rid of that sucking noise that we hear on a lot of forks out there. And just makes it that much quieter. It's one less thing to worry about when you're on trail.
Yep, I've had one ride so far on the new Zeb and no swishing noise that you can kind of get from other forks. So that's an added bonus, you know, kind of peace of mind. You can listen to nature out there.
Mm-hmm.
One other thing on these damper assemblies, that little gold thing. It looks fancy. It's not part of the rebound assembly. What is that guy?
Looks fancy, but it's actually pretty simple. Not to say that it's a useless piece, far from it. This is called Buttercups. You heard about it when they released Flight Attendant earlier this year. And inside this gold puck here is actually just a piece of vibration damping rubber, similar, you know, it looks like what you'd see on a bump stop on a coil sprung shock. And what is happening here is that this shaft is actually attached via that damper to the bottom of the fork. So your fork lowers. So any vibrations that are coming up through the wheel into the fork and then up into your handlebars are now mitigated by this little high frequency vibration damper. And it's just one more thing to improve the ride. And like Rich said, this is both on the damper side as well as the air spring side. They've done all the testing. You can look at the charts, and it does in fact make a noticeable difference despite being such a simple piece. Now, I mentioned the air spring. You've got some thoughts on that.
Yeah, so RockShox has also completely redesigned the air springs on these. It's now called the Debonair Plus. And as we mentioned before, each of these forks has an intended travel range. So Pike for your shorter downcountry bikes, Lyrik for your all mountain trail bikes, and the Zeb for your big enduro and free ride rigs. So with those new air shafts, they have machined them to be specific to those travel ranges. So better small bump compliance. That's something we all love to see on a fork. In the aftermarket, they are going to be different colors, so it's easy to identify them. The air spring in the Zeb will be gold, the air spring in the Lyrik will be red, and then in the Pike, it will be silver. So it makes it easy when you go into your local shop to change the travel on your fork to identify which air spring you will need. Another thing to note on the Charger 3 damper and these air springs is they are not going to be compatible with your previous model year forks. So if you have an old Lyrik, you got an old Pike, you unfortunately can't get Charger 3, can't get Buttercups, can't get Debonair Plus. But if you have a previous model Zeb, which is what I'm currently running, I can upgrade that fork from the Charger 2.1 to a Charger 3 damper, and I can also do the new air spring, and I can add Buttercups, which is really cool. So if you need a new fork, you're looking at the Pike and the Lyrik, brand new setup. If you have a Zeb, you just want to upgrade it, that's a pretty cool thing you can do.
So that Maxima plush fluid, however, is a worthwhile upgrade. Next time you get your fork serviced, make sure it's with that stuff.
Yep.
So I talked about how RockShox’s catered their line of forks to specific intended riding styles. They've kind of done a similar thing with their shocks, which they have completely redesigned as well. We're going to talk about the Super Deluxe Ultimate in this case. There's both a new air shock and coil shock.
Yeah, so on these new shocks, the whole Super Deluxe Ultimate lineup, they have a new damper. It's a bit of a mouthful. It's called the RC2T. Now, try and say that 10 times fast. But it's actually pretty easy to know what all of those letters and numbers stand for, and I'm going to run you through it. So first up is rebound. That's the R. On the air shocks, it's going to be located in the same spot, right at the top of the shock. You're going to have 15 clicks of adjustment there. And on the coils, they've moved it down here to the bottom. You got this little knob here. They've thought about it because sometimes this is in a hard to reach spot. You got a 3mm Allen key. They've got some nice little indentations on the side that you can get that Allen key into, and again, get those 15 clicks of rebound adjustment. Now, the C2 stands for compression twice. Again, like the forks, they have high and low speed compression adjustment. You have a tool-free low speed compression adjustment. That one's gonna be tool-free because that's the one you're most likely to adjust on the trail. And then they have a high speed compression adjustment that again, 3mm Allen key, you can adjust it there. Both of these guys have 5 different settings, and like the forks, they have a nice middle neutral setting. So you can start there and then either go 2 clicks up or 2 clicks down from there. Finally, the last thing, the T, is what RockShox is calling threshold, and that's their pedaling platform. So it's on the opposite side from the low speed compression. It's this little dial here. It's a lockout for your rear shocks. This is available on both the coil and the air shocks. So we've got all of those new damper settings here on the new coil and air shocks. There's also one new feature that's pretty exciting. What is that, Dan?
Yeah, this is a cool thing. RockShox’s has introduced a hydraulic bottom out on both the Super Deluxe Air and Coil. They do function a little bit differently, but what they both are is a hydraulic bottom out, so that means fluid through an orifice that gets closed off, making it harder to compress the shock in only the last 20% of the stroke. So that's just down here at the bottom. You'll see this on shocks with some of that cool anodization that RockShox’s does. It's noted on there, well, on the air shock anyway. And it makes it, yeah, that much harder to bottom out the shock in that last 20% of the stroke. On the air shock, this is not adjustable the way that an air spring works, it being innately progressive. They're designed to work together to prevent that bottom out. However, on the coil shock, you will see a little purple tooled adjuster here at the top. And with that, you can increase or decrease the how severe that hydraulic bottom out is in that last 20%. It'll work in conjunction with an all new material bottom out puck that you see here down at the bottom. And you know, if you're hucking off cliffs out in Utah, you can bump that all the way up. Or if you're, you know, racing downhill on some smoother trails or something like that on a flow trail up at Whistler, you can back that off and use all that travel really smoothly.
So that's a pretty awesome feature, something that no one else is really doing on their rear shocks. Mm-hmm. So tunability is obviously a big one with the new RockShox’s suspension, and they've worked with a bunch of different frame manufacturers to get the perfect settings for your bike. And like we mentioned on that damper, there's going to be a nice neutral setting. That's where they've kind of tuned that shock to work with your bike, and then you can make small adjustments from there to really fine tune that ride. And again, it's less intimidating, so that's pretty cool. There's another way that you can tune these shocks on the air shock though, Dan.
Yep.
What is that?
To bring that home to the end user and to really allow you to get the shock feeling exactly how you want it, RockShox’s has introduced two air cans with their new Super Deluxe Ultimate, well, the Super Deluxe line. There is a linear can, which will work well for most people and most bikes. That's what we see here. There's also a progressive can, which, like the MegNeg can that you might remember, increases the negative air chamber. So in relation to the positive air chamber, it's now a sort of a smaller positive chamber relative to the negative. That'll give you more bottom out resistance. It'll also increase your mid-stroke support. Now, this is something that RockShox’s will work with some brands to include stock on these bikes. You can also, if you're finding you really need it, upgrade or swap the air can on your current Super Deluxe Ultimate. Along with that, they have also introduced, of course, volume reducers that work in both the positive air chamber and the negative air chamber, so you can really get very sort of dialed in on how this thing feels.
So just like forks, these rear shocks will be available in the aftermarket. Obviously there's lots of different sizes and mounting styles. If you got any questions about that, you can give us a call. We can help you out with that. Figure out which coil or air shock is gonna be right for your bike. Good news, all of the coils from the old shocks are compatible with the new ones. And another cool feature, they have made sure that these coil shocks are compatible with bikes that use a yoke. So some of those bikes, they put a lot of stress on the shaft of a coil spring. They don't really work well with those bikes, but something like a Stumpy Evo, you could put the new Super Deluxe Ultimate coil on there. So yeah, that's a pretty cool thing.
Yeah, we're betting we're gonna see some people want an upgrade. One last thing about the coil shock, or rather either of these shocks and that new hydraulic bottom out, is some people in the forums were opening these up to cut off the little travel reducer spacers. But these new ones, because of that hydraulic bottom out and that pin that enters that orifice at the last 20% of the stroke, that will impact and break your shock. So don't be doing that on these. There's plenty of really experienced shock tuners out there. If you wanna change the travel of your shock, give us a call and we can help you out. Now, if you have any questions about any of this stuff, the new Super Deluxe Ultimate Coil Air, the new Pike, the new Lyrik, which is coming in that cool Heather Meadows green, or the new Zeb that Rich has got here on his fork, leave us a comment below. We'll get back to you. We'll answer those questions for you. If you like watching these videos, please do subscribe to our channel and hit that little bell so you're notified when we put out a new video. That helps us a lot. And of course, if you have any questions for us directly, give us a call, 1-844-326-2845. That's 1-844-FANATIC. Or shoot us an email, sales@fanaticbike.com. Thanks, y'all.